YouTube has a real algorithm. But it's late at night, Alfred rhythm. And we just started playing this game. As soon as we got done doing World of Warcraft, we were doing Darksiders. Which was fighting a big, big dragon titty bitch.
She was a badass, actually.
What was that thing I was talking about?
You didn't get the joke there when I said that Dracula was bad.
Yeah. The achievement I got.
It's fucked up.
still been going on a fasting kick.
Somewhat. I wouldn't necessarily call it a fast, but it's kind of a fast. I only have a certain calorie amount that I can actually eat solid food in a day. And normally in a day I would consume, like during the daytime I would consume like, I think it's like 2,000 calories.
Yeah.
But during the day I toned it down to a max of 700. 700 calories in a day.
Do you know what life is called? Yubi?
Yellow.
You know what you'd be called?
Mm-hmm.
A pineapple.
There's no way that she'd be the strongest in this video. Could you imagine if you changed, if you got like the Mandalorian lightsaber and you changed the crystal in it? If it would still be like the katana beam, or if it would be a round beam.
There's a mock up on here.
There is.
For like PC version of it.
Oh, sad.
There's no way to mock up on here. That's why I know.
Sad.
If there was, I would have definitely had a Mandalorian lightsaber.
I still say when we get the Dubro Studios stuff completely up and going, I'm going to buy the Force Unleashed set. But didn't you say they were remastering it soon?
It was in
Resident Evil.
I know there was a Knights of the Old Republic remake coming along.
Because I think the reason why I like the Force Unleashed more than this game is the customization feature.
That's also during the time when there was a lot of customization. This is like right after.
God damn it, Panda.
The Clone Wars.
Is that Panda?
That's Thor. I see your white tail.
God damn it. I love you, Bubba, but these dogs get into way too much shit. I would have to say though, this bat looks a lot more cuddlier than the other one. Like, if it wasn't trying to kill you, you'd probably try to cuddle it.
Yeah. If someone doesn't have cuddles.
My hair's getting longer.
Yeah.
I can't wait for it to start getting, like, super fucking long.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Because I'm going to see if I can find somebody that knows how to do the Viking center braid. I'm going to get my hair braided.
Oh, cool.
You know, like the layered interwoven braid.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, I was nervous about going and getting this haircut.
Yeah.
Super nervous. Like, what happens if they didn't do it right? What happened if I got it and didn't like it? You know?
I'm glad you do like it.
Mostly because I can do this, it makes me feel like a valiant steed. I had to make up a lie to convince myself to go get this haircut.
Yeah.
You know what it was? I told the lady that was cutting my hair. She asked me, "Sally, why are you getting a haircut like this?" And I'm like, "Well, me and my brother-in-law, we're video game streamer type people, and we kind of had a bet going to see who would finish God of War first."
Yeah.
And I lost, so I had to get the haircut. I mean, technically, that wasn't a complete lie.
No. No, it wasn't a complete truth, but...
Did he just pick up
scaring the living shit out of me. All I hear is, and I'm like, baby, I'm mourning.
You're not dying. You're holding on by off the way.
I like what I see right now.
I bet you do. I like what I'm seeing too.
I've seen thighs.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know, after seeing that vampire chick from the Resident Evil at the king, nothing else, just nothing else looks good.
Except for Reese. Except for Reese. You always have a moment for Reese.
I do.
Exactly. I don't know, it feels kind of wrong looting the character from Resident Evil, period. I don't know why.
Yeah, Liz, at one point from the first day as a joke, she's gonna find somebody that looks close to Riaz and have them stripped from the first day. I'm like, that wouldn't be a good idea. And she's like, why? You know, like, because I couldn't keep my hands off them. I'd be like, Riaz Grimory, I will take your essence. And throw them on the bed and. Wouldn't be the first bitch me and my wife tag team. Especially on this group. Isaac.
Kerr.
You know my new saying. If the ceiling's squeaking, don't come peeking. Thinking of like a golden chicken with like humongous biceps, just like, bruh. Like a heavenly rooster. I just made a new god, the god of KFC. Have you ever seen like fast food mascots and like the JoJo's reference?
Oh my god, Burger King, Donald Jr. reference. That has to exist.
I mean, it's a really fucking high fantasy.
You slow as shit, bro, man.
Did I?
You died.
I was...
I have to say, though, since we started this, like, low-dairy diet because of Vicky, my stomach hasn't been hurting as much. Anybody else notice anything different since we... Oh, she's starting to get a little baby gut, and that's not healthy. Climb, Cal, you useless bastard. We're gonna die! She doesn't say.
Oh, there's a mouthwash, huh?
Stabby, 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 stabby. He's like, God, if this doesn't fucking work, we are fucked.
Cause I'm free falling.
I guess you gotta try to fall on his back.
Are you?
You failed.
I've been falling for 30 fucking minutes! didn't even try on. Nah. Motherfucker.
How old were you?
15. In video game time, that was 30 minutes.
Well, you don't really do much around. Just to make sure you're...
There's the mantis. Did you change his, thing?
Yeah.
It's just one. Don't shoot that man. I think a lot of, like, African American people have offended at that. I've heard, like, some people were actually recently petitioning to get that phrase, that line cut out of the episode. The episode be redone. And most of them were, Black Lives Matter activists.
If you're gonna do that, you might as well just do the whole fucking armor.
Yeah. They were wanting more specification.
Oh. You want them to don't shoot Ethan Boca Black?
Yes.
I can kind of do that, but I still say they should leave him alone because it's hilarious.
Yeah.
If you're falling for it, fucking throwing.
Sudden we look back at it. All of a sudden all you hear is is Vicky still asleep?
Yeah, she's asleep.
I swear to God I keep hearing that. I'm just running. Try not to die! Oh, how the fuck was that even possible?
Open space.
God damn it, Cal.
You worthless ass bastard.
Okay, so it's a one-way only. I miss Red Fox. I wish we would have gotten his contact info.
At least his YouTube.
Yeah. So we could all be like two bros.
You know what? I don't want to be. I really. You know what? I'm just gonna walk around. Seems like you're gonna walk around. Well,
I think I kind of have to.
Sure, guys, I'm joining you.
Hey, we're all in this. It's a three-way battle, man.
We're all in this together, as they say in High School Musical.
We're all in this together.
I'm...
Yes. Am I the only one that thinks that was, like, the worst fucking movie that Zac Efron has ever been in?
Yeah.
I mean, dude was, like, what, in his early 30s playing as a...
I'm trying to get the thing in the hole to go all the way down. I can't get it to go all the way in.
Chris, how many women have you slept with?
I'm just curious about you. I'm just asking like it.
And then, you know, answer your question. Answer your question. What's an honest question? Answer your question.
I'm fucking dead.
Stuff, right?
Oh, what?
Come on, we'll see you to be later today.
You guys don't hear that shit.
Yeah. I'm not even a little I don't know why I feel so comfortable with fucking vending machine at you. I'm gonna throw a vending machine at you. Call that motherfucker, I brought change. Oh, the things they could have said to Aurora. The vending machine part I got from an anime.
Yeah.
And there's a guy who's like really strong with clock. He has storm vending machines at this one dude.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's why I got that.
It's shit, Alex.
It's, I think it's after 2, actually.
It is.
Yep. Rule applies, because it's after 2 o'clock.
This motherfucker looks like 10 witches out here.
I bring drugs.
Wait a minute.
I will share if you guys stop hitting me. Okay, I guess I gotta kill these motherfuckers. More drugs for me. That motherfucker has a bucket as well. That was the motherfucker that killed you.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, fuck. I would try force pushing them, bitches.
Yeah.
It won't work. You ain't got enough force in your push.
It's too far away. Yeah, yeah, sure. We'll
get the joke.
That's what I say. Well, that's what I said. Like, yeah, sure, we'll go with that.
Get all the motherfuckers again. Oh, I see.
I was trying to do it without the.
I gotta climb the fungus.
There's a fungus among us!
It's a Mountain Dew. Fuck Faygo. You know why I say fuck Faygo? Because they only make certain pops and die.
That sounds like a...
Yeah.
What about the people that got diabetes? Like me. To enjoy Faygo.
The only diet pops I've ever seen is diet cream soda, of course the diet cola, and diet Faygo pop.
Mm-hmm.
And I think there was one time I found diet root beer, but those aren't my favorite pops.
What is your favorite one?
Moon Mist. Moon Mist is one of my favorites. I mean, like, I'll drink the diet cola. But it's not as good, you know?
Yeah.
Got a new poncho.
It's called Beta Bomb.
Call me what you will. Somebody on Chesterton Garage Sale is selling a Lowell's $50 gift card for $35.
You can't tell me that it's not a cord.
Oh my gosh.
They rescued them, finally realized they weren't puppies.
They look like puppies.
The fuck are they?
Oh, yeah.
Firefighters put their lives on the line on the
Storm drain, which was a fairly common scenario for this experienced team. Luckily, it was a sunny day in March, and the weather was on their side. They didn't have to deal with heavy rain or with a storm, which could put these animals in danger. Because they had to be really small to fit inside. The team of experienced firefighters had no time to waste and knew exactly their first step was getting the animals back to safety. The animals they came across were the only, were only a few hours or days old, and it was critical to locate their mother so they could be reunited. They shouldn't be left to fend for themselves at such an early age. Locating her would also help them determine what kind of animal they were dealing with. Okay, if you don't know,
what?
You don't know what kind of animal they are, how would you know what the mother looks like? Like, that would be, like, simple deduction skills, right?
Right.
So the firefighters decided to do everything they could to find the mother. Unfortunately, the mother was nowhere to be found, and the group of brave firefighters feared that
any animal had been abandoned.
Or were there those animals that, you know, left behind at a really young age?
Like turtles. Firefighters are not void of emotion, despite the fact they deal with distressing situations on a daily basis. And they thought that something left these younglings to fend for themselves inside the storm drain broke their hearts. They were even more determined to rescue the animals and give them the safe home they deserve. But that was easier said than done. These tiny creatures deserved a shot at life, just like anyone else, but there was so much more to them than the firefighters found themselves facing a difficult decision after they found the baby animals because they didn't have all the facts. They couldn't know for sure if their mother left them for good or if she was simply looking for food for her newborns. If the mother is still in the picture, it would have given would be a grave mistake to take her babies away, but she wasn't showing up. The time was running out, and they couldn't leave the animals there for much longer because they desperately needed proper care. I know. It was impossible for firefighters to give these tiny creatures the care they deserve without knowing which species they belong to. Because different animals have different needs. Oh shit. If they belong to a domestic species, it was incredibly important to get them immediate assistance. But that wasn't always the case with wild animals, unless they were in immediate danger. It's a better idea to leave them be so they can learn to defend themselves and survive in the wild. Once they finally got a closer look at these marvelous babies, the firefighters were pretty sure they knew what they were dealing with. They assumed that the animals in question were puppies, but the fact they were hiding inside the storm drain was still confusing. After many years on the job, they never found dogs inside a storm drain before, and that discovery left them scratching their heads. They decided to investigate the issue and knew exactly what to look, where to look for the answer they needed. The team of firefighters had a hunch that the owner was to blame for these alleged pups. Unfortunate fate, but they didn't want to jump to any conclusions before having actual proof that they, that their heart was in the right place. They tracked down the woman who called them, and she reassured them that, as far as she knows, the pups weren't left there by anyone. The firefighters were glad to hear that human cruelty didn't lead to this, but there were still many questions left unanswered. Sorry if I'm boring you guys with this shit. It's really shitty writing. Like, I could have wrote this whole thing, you know, in like maybe 3 paragraphs.
I just think you can do better.
Like, there's a lot of unnecessary buzz and ands, and
that's just
like, it's really shitty writing.
It's just really improper grammar.
Yeah. Like, I'm cutting a lot of the shit out to try to make it flow better.
I'm kidding.
I'm doing the best I can. There's a lot of bullshit here. When Captain Brian Volgran? V-A-U-G-H-A-N. Volgran. Discussing the rescue mission with Inside Edition, he said it took the team about 20 minutes to get the animals back to safety. And added that at first they were concerned it was another case of dog dumping, which in some states is illegal.
Dog dumping is, I think it can be up to $1,000 per pup. Cats, on the other hand, they're not too worried about.
Because they can think of it.
Well, not only that. A cat can get out and survive by itself.
Yeah.
A lot better than a dog can. A dog sees a human come at it, they're not going to really necessarily run away. They're going to try to go after that human and possibly cause some serious damage. A cat, on the other hand, cat comes running up after you to attack you. What's the first thing you're going to do?
Kick it.
Exactly.
I mean, that's the first thing I'll do if I see a dog coming at me too, but I'm a little retarded, so.
I mean, I don't have a flight response. I don't know what it is. I've never had a flight response.
Oh, cool. I don't know what it is.
Their first priority was to make sure that the tiny creatures were safe and healthy. Unfortunately, there wasn't much else they could do for the pups after picking them out of the storm drain.
And they had to hand them to licensed animal experts who could give them proper care. Once they did, they realized this wasn't at all what they had expected. The weather was pretty mild. Thank you. lit region, and once one of the firefighters left them his home number just in case, the Humane Society usually works with the domestic animals, including cats, dogs, rats, pigs, chickens, so the team thought they could definitely help with the helpless pups they had rescued. But as it quickly turned out, this organization wasn't even licensed to take care of these animals, since they didn't fall under any of these categories. Then the team of firefighters got a call back from the Humane Society. They feared the worst. The pups were in a pretty worrisome condition. Then they found chances of survival were pretty bad since their mother wasn't around. Fortunately, the vet didn't call with bad news. The tiny creatures they found were safe and sound, but the vet had another important piece of information to share with the firefighters. His words took them by surprise and made them look at this mission from a brand new perspective. After hanging up the call with the vet, the firefighters realized how clueless they were when it comes to detecting animal species. It turned out that the litter of quote-unquote Labrador pups weren't Labradors at all. As a matter of fact, they weren't even puppies. The vet informed them that the 8 dogs they rescued were actually newborn fox kits. It was a hilarious mistake, and he didn't judge them for mistaking them with pups since they look pretty similar at such a young age. I am not reading any more of this shit, because it goes on for like another fucking 3 paragraphs. Long story short, they were fox pups.
Including there was a fox.
There were fox puppers.
Chaos.
Huh? That's what, you know, fox pups are called. They're called kits. K-I-T-S. Kits.
You okay?
Oh, Order 66 was to kill all the Jedi. So what, he was probably 10 years old in this, and now he's like, what, in his 20s?
Mm-hmm.
So it's safe to say that his master never came.
Yeah. Well, you're fine.
Are they trying to stop you from getting to the, escape pods?
No, they're killing... What the fuck? They're killing everyone. Yes, even
young ones.
Even young ones.
You want a pop tart, Mama? Oh, that's right. At least that same race as that one chick. So small, I must protect. How did Jedi Masters become one of the first Jedi? Mm-hmm. He cries like a fucking whiny-ass ginger.
I don't blame him.
Have you ever heard a ginger whine?
Yeah.
It's the most annoying thing ever. Like, I want to punch a whining ginger in the face.
You just have a friend of a ginger.
I think I actually, yeah, when we were at boys' school, there was this one ginger kid
from Walmart.
His name was Sam, and he always fucking whined over the stupidest of shit. And one time I got tired of it, and I just went right up to him and bloodied his fucking face like my punch. And the staff member asked me why they do that, and I'm like, I don't know what it is. It's just a cool, like a whiny ginger makes me mad. It makes me want to rip his heart out of his chest. And then of course that's not really your master, bro. I still want to punch him in the face, Cal. He gripped it too hard and I couldn't work.
And this next one is going to take 2 to 3 hours.
After I get all hard and actually want to watch this.
Yes, I am. We'll see you guys.